Welcome to the first race of the new ARCSOA Elite Series, Season 25, here at the Road Atlanta Circuit, here for the first Grand Prix, or for the next running of the Grand Prix of Road Atlanta, the first race of the season. We are here for a very ecstatic race here at the Road Atlanta Circuit. We're expecting it to be traditionally chaotic, as per normal, as 25 drivers will take the start here today, hopefully, provided they all start, here at Road Atlanta. Without further ado, let's go down to your starting grid. Starting on pole, we have Eric Monaco, and alongside of him, we have Noah Hart. Monaco's got his first ever ARCSOA Elite Series pole for Silver Speed, and Noah Hart driving for his own family team, Fuel Brothers Racing. Behind him, we have Kenny Myatt, the master of Road Atlanta, and alongside of him, we have DJ Curtis in the Roush Racing Mustang. Christian Vanderpesch and Madeline Myatt round out row three. Tim Fiegel, long time since we've seen that name, and Aiden Shepherd are on the next row of the grid. Alexander Spencer, a rookie from Great Britain, along with Jesse Turner. Meme Ratzenberger alongside of Zachary Fitzwater. Nick Pericles alongside Ryan Humpf, Sean Perkins and Cody Lamas. Jacob Hart and Tyler Thaber. Johannes Roydevera and Benoit Lothaire Ravine, both rookies on the grid. Clara Irwin and Maverick Force. And we now have Do It For Dale Jr., Vince Freeze, and Kitsune Hashimoto rounds out the grid here. The Ferraris have not been the quickest cars on the grid so far today, or so far in preseason testing. The Ferrari team of Hashimoto and Roydevera, two rookies here, is Eric Monaco. Pace car is going in. Eric Monaco in the Silver Speed. His teammate is Nick Pericles in the 82 car. And we are racing here at Road Atlanta! As here they go, down into turn number one. Noah Hart doesn't get a great start. Myatt's already up to second position here. As they are now trying to fight down Eric Monaco in the back. It's so far a pretty orderly start today here at Road Atlanta, as it looks like Vanderpesch is going to get third away from Hart as well. Oh, there's Tim Fiegel sliding all over the place. Gets into his teammate. That's Alexander Spencer. And around they go. Manny Myatt in. That is Aiden Shepherd are out. Or got taken out in that incident there. As the field all rockets down. The two Fusion Sports cars of Jesse Turner and Ryan Hobb get a great start on the grid. They're already battling up for 6th and 7th. Oh, contact there between DJ Curtis and Noah Hart. They're beating and banging down Death Valley for the first time here, as Eric Monaco's got to be loving the fact that he got away from that. Tim Fiegel drops all the way to last. He's got a tire going down. Actually, both DNCs. Oh, Do It For Dale Jr. is around, and he has a lot of front-end damage to that car. We're going to take a look to see what happened to him. As, oh, Myatt's off the road. Vanderpesch is going by on the inside. And Vanderpesch up to P2. Not often that you see somebody really outwit Kenny Myatt on this track. And this is what happened to Do It For Dale Jr. and Benoit Lothaire Ravine. They would reckon For Dale would go around there. Do It For Dale Jr., of course, the son of Do It For Dale Sr., who was a famous ARC driver. Very popular at this track, Do It For Dale Jr. from Canapolis, North Carolina. Aiden Shepherd is battling there. I believe that's with Roydevera, and they're going to wreck off. Oh, no! There goes Shepherd and Roydevera! Roydevera's going to keep going, but Shepherd's going to get it beached out there. Tough break for Shepherd. The fastest car on the track right now is Christian Vanderpesch, as he's reeling in Eric Monaco there, the Dutch driver. From near Zandvoort, is now closing in on Eric Monaco for the lead of this race. Kenny Myatt is in a distant third. His car doesn't look, the 9 doesn't look very strong today, as DJ Curtis is in fourth position. Out of the three cars up there, actually, Kenny Myatt's the slowest of the bunch, and he is losing speed relatively quickly, actually, there. A little through the field here, there's Roydevera. Sean Perkins did not get a great start to this season. Nick Pericles also had a very slow qualifying session and actually got held up by some slow cars in a traffic of accidents there. Vince Fries didn't get a great start either in the 50 car. Fries is, of course, one of the future stars of the series. Kind of made a surprise move by going to Roush Racing there. There's Kitsune Hashimoto. Oh, Fries and Pericles are off the road. Pericles won this race. Oh, big contact there for Vince Fries. He slammed that wall pretty good there. Pericles has won this race before. Hashimoto not doing well. There's one of the Lexus Team Canada cars of Maverick Force. Canadian driver from just outside Vancouver. Maverick Force is going to be one to watch. There's Jacob Hart. Didn't qualify very well here for being one of the better drivers on Road Atlanta in the 19 car. Up the order, we have Cody Lamas in the Fordale Enterprises car. There's Clara Irwin and Main Ratzenberger, another rookie from Germany. I'm probably going to pronounce that name wrong all season. Zachary Fitzwater, another near winner here a couple of times. Tyler Thaber doing a very good job here, as Jesse Turner is way faster than his teammate Ryan Hopft. Hopft hasn't been in this series in a long, long time. And it's interesting to see what Hopft's going to do with that car. Jesse Turner was the ARCSOA Lights rookie last season. Actually, two seasons ago, because there was no ARCSOA last season, just an American 700. Noah Hart now is in fifth position, trying to hold on to the back of this group. Hart is quick, though. And now Kenny Myatt is slowly reeling in some of the cars in front of him. Battle on track forming between Thaber and Fitzwater here. Two of the wily veterans of the series, Australian Zachary Fitzwater and Tyler Thaber. As you know, ARCSOA went through a lot of financial problems, and an Australian consortium has bought the series, so there's a lot of Australian support in this series. We're expecting at least two. Oh, no! No, 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 no! No, no, no! That's Thaber off the road after a great start in a very underpowered Fordale Enterprises car, and I think Fitzwater just dumped him. And that's not going to go well for Fitzwater with the race stewards. Oh, there's Thaber off the road again. Ah, Thaber's done now. Oh, man, the Fordale cars aren't exactly the best on the grid, but that's not going to be good for him, as that is also freezes in the pits as well. Battle for third heating up between DJ Curtis and Kenny Myatt here. DJ Curtis, one of the best road racers, and Kenny Myatt, of course, is an absolute master of this track. That looked like Curtis got a great run there coming out of the twin corners down to Death Valley. That one corner is probably the most important one on the track. As here, Vanderpesh is trying to set up Monaco as well. Pit stops are going to be real interesting in this race, as it looks like the top four are all lockstep with each other, as Hart had a terrible start. But Hart is actually... these guys all start battling. Hart could close in pretty quickly on this group. This is effectively what killed off Tyler Thaber, is actually that's Nick Pericles would hit him. Pericles, well, it looked like Thaber was trying to get that one's on Thaber there. And he didn't like the way that Pericles hit him there and kind of tried to pay the price, and Pericles had none of it. DJ Curtis in the last couple of laps has fallen way off of Kenny Myatt in third, as Myatt now is closing back in on the leading two. Well, actually, Vanderpesh is the fastest car on the grid, but I think he's actually being held up by the dirty air off the 83 car of Monaco. So Eric Monaco has never, I believe, won an ARCSOA Elite Series race, so this could be an interesting day for him. Bad exit through the corner there by Monaco, and Vanderpesh is all over Monaco here as they go down the hill. Up the hill they go now through the S's there. It's all up to Vanderpesh to get a great run off the corner. Doesn't look like he did there, though. Crazy battles back here for 8th on back as Jacob Hart has gotten by Cody Lamas. That's Mean Ratzenberger. Clara Irwin, Zachary Fitzwater had a pretty poor corner there, and Sean Perkins, they're all lockstep with each other. Maverick Force is back there as well, with Kitsune Hashimoto and Nick Pericles also there. And, oh, Pericles and Hashimoto might be going at it here down the hill. Pericles is quick. Pericles is actually surprisingly 2 seconds faster than everybody around him, so... he'll be flying through the field, I think, here pretty quickly. Vanderpesh is all over the back of Monaco now here in the middle of lap 10. And this could be a very, very fun race for these two gentlemen as they rocket their way around this circuit. Will Vandy be able to make a move here on Monaco? Jesse Turner is a man on a mission now as he's reeling in Noah Hart rapidly here in the 99 X-Side Fusion here for Fusion Sport. And as he rockets down into the chicane, watch Jesse Turner. He's setting times comparable to the leaders of this race. Actually, he's one of the fastest cars on the track right now. Excuse me? Jesse Turner could be one to watch as this race continues. Vanderpesh is making a move now on Monaco through the S's. Will he be able to make this move stick as he goes down the hill? Vanderpesh now. Ooh, there's a little bit of sliding there by Vanderpesh as he tried to make a move on Monaco. Monaco defends brilliantly there. A little further back, you got DJ Curtis and Kenny Myatt. They're going to be doing battle as well. So the top four are all regrouping again for another rather interesting race here. Monaco has never won an ARCSOA Elite Series race, and winning it at Road Atlanta would prove that he is one of the best. Vanderpesh seems really good through the rest of the track that is not the S's, because that's where Vanderpesh loses a lot of his ground there on Eric Monaco here. But see, all this battling has really made DJ Curtis and especially Jesse Turner and Noah Hart close in on the leading three. Canadian Clara Irwin has a problem with the 81 car and the Lexus Team Canada car. Not quite sure what's wrong with it, but she finally gets going after a very, very long pit stop. Like I said, I'm not exactly sure what was the issue there with Irwin's car. Eric Monaco now has to lap. That is Alexander Spencer, the British driver, the British rookie, coming out of British Touring Cars. And Alex Spencer is really holding up poor Eric Monaco there. Not in a good spot either. And this is going to be very aggressive here. Monaco nearly gets into him. The top three are all together. Monaco goes off the track and Vanderpesh is in the lead of the race. And oh, there's DJ Curtis, sir. That's Vanderpesh going off the track. Myatt's somehow in the lead of the race now. I don't know how that one happened, but we're going to have to take a look at that. But Myatt's somehow in the lead with Vanderpesh second, Curtis third, and the big loser. Oh, Eric Monaco must hit the tire wall. Oh, he had this race leading it. And oh, man, he's in trouble now. He's in big, big trouble. Yeah, Monaco's driving his butt off there trying to lap Spencer, and Spencer's not exactly giving him the best chance. Spencer runs him off the road. Then, oh, coming out of the corner there, DJ Curtis gets a little bit of a nudge from Myatt as Myatt takes this opportunity to take the lead of the race. So now Myatt's got to deal with Spencer, though. Zachary Fitzwater would also fall out of the race with a mechanical problem as well. He had some mechanical problems after an accident with some of the back markers on lap one. So tough break for Fitzwater. Myatt leads this race, but now Vanderpesh is closing in with DJ Curtis in third. Curtis has, I think, nearly come close to winning this race plenty of times. But now Myatt leading this race is not good for everybody else, because you know Kenny Myatt on this track is very opportunistic. And him giving a slight little nudge to Vanderpesh. I think I've called him Curtis in the past, because Curtis has previously driven that car. But Myatt has been... Oh, here comes Vandy now, trying to make a move here on Myatt. Is Myatt going to leave the door open? Vanderpesh has the best car out there right now. But, oh, Vanderpesh is going to make a move here. There's contact. Vandy's off the road. Oh, gets into Curtis. Oh, no. They're both off. And did that just seal it for Kenny Myatt, do you think? And Curtis is in the fence. Or is it the tires? Vandy gets going. But Curtis is done. Oh, man. Curtis's bad luck at Road Atlanta continues here at ARCSOA. Another series DJ Curtis has won here in the past, but I don't think he's going to be doing that today with that hood like that. This started with a very opportunistic move by Christian Vanderpesh, and Vanderpesh goes underneath the 9, and, well, the 9 is holding his line. They make contact, and, well, Vanderpesh goes around, and that's where Curtis, kind of the innocent bystander there. Isn't this a surprise? The 9's in the lead at Road Atlanta. I'm totally surprised at this. Not really at all. This is just something that we've seen before here. Vanderpesh is still somehow in second. Now you got Noah Hart in third. fourth. So this is going to be one heck of a race to see who wins this one. If Mayan, something happens to Mayan, because right now I don't think Mayan's going to be very easily caught below, to say the least. Noah Hart seems to be quick compared to Mayan. Kenny Mayan's coming up to lap his daughter, Madeline Mayan, who got taken out in an incident on lap one. Maddie Mayan was actually fastest in final practice. Former champions, Colt Lamar, as they go down the hill. I'm guessing Madeline Mayan's not going to be too hard on her father here. Although, it doesn't seem like Kenny Mayan's really wanting to do a whole lot around Maddie Mayan, but I digress there. As the 9 of Kenny Mayan is now just kind of backing off and not wanting to get involved with the 91 car of Maddie Mayan there. As, the 91 goes a little wide there. And this is going to be interesting as they're kind of come up to lap mean Ratzenberger. And, Maddie Myatt's getting actually kind of aggressive to try and hold her spot on the lead lap. And Kenny Myatt's not exactly happy with his daughter. Kind of shakes the fist going by there. Not going to be a very pleasant dinner table there between the two of them. Noah Hart and Jesse Turner do short pit here to try and get themselves back on the lead lap here, or try and get themselves in a better position here, so I'm going to be interested to see if this pays off for them. Ratzenberger is holding up Kenny Mayan, the race leader here, and this is actually going to prevent him, I think, from pitting this time. Ratzenberger does get a bit of the curve there, and oh! There's a little bit of contact there between the two of them. Mayan can't pit, and Mayan was trying to signal to pit in his Patronus, so this could end up being a bad thing for Kenny Mayan. He's going to have to go into emergency fuel conservation mode to just get it back to the pits, because he's got to do a whole extra lap that he wasn't planning on doing, as Ratzenberger is being a very big nuisance here to the 9 car, as the 70 is duking it out with him. I didn't think that Roush family racing car was going to be that strong of a car. Ratzenberger's going to slide a bit there as Mayan finally gets by him. Battle for position on track as Noah Hart was leaving the pits, and oh, there goes Vince Freeze off the road, and he's going to go into the tires because he can't control his car. Kenny Mayan breaks down the road. Actually, Vanderpesh is joining him. Vanderpesh is really closed in on the 9, because Vanderpesh, as we said, is the fastest car on track right now. Gonna be interesting to see. Oh, here comes the two few, or here comes Ryan Hopped into the pits as well. Actually, we actually have a car that is staying out even longer here. That would be Cody Lamas. Lamas takes over the lead of this race since he is on a very different pitch. And he loaded his car full of fuel at the start of the race. Some of these other drivers were short pitting, as it seems. As here comes the 9 and the 7 out of the pits here. They only have 11 laps of fuel in their car. Ben Waller, Sarah Ravine. Actually, Noah Hart and Jesse Turner are going to lose positions by short pitting, as Ryan Hopp and Jacob Hart are actually going to leapfrog them, as has Ben Waller, Sarah Ravine. So, not a great stop for either Ryan Hopp or, Jesse Turner or Noah Hart there. The big beneficiary of that whole thing was actually Cody Lamas, as he slots into third position by long pitting there. With only 9 laps to go, that might have been the move of the race, because he was running in the mid, around 8th all day. Ryan Hopped also doing a great job. Haven't seen his name in a long time on the grid. There's Jacob Hart also behind him. That's going to be a battle to watch there as this race keeps going. Here is Vanderpesh now is closing in very quickly here on Kenny Mayan for the lead of this race, so Alexander Spencer has a problem on his car as well, so tough break for Spencer. Ryan Hopped would get by Cody Lamas on track, though, as Lamas is very slow. Oh, Lamas has damage! What happened to Lamas? Lamas has a lot of damage there, so he must have gotten into an accident with somebody there. And, he's going to be slow. Well, Kenny Mayan must have just been showing off, because he's setting the fastest lap of the race right now, or he did last time by, and I think, well, he didn't beat it that time, but overall, he's the fastest car on the track right now, so I think Kenny Mayan is going to somehow get his, 7th Road Atlanta win? I don't know. Maddie Mayan's car has gotten into an accident before coming out of the corner here, and this actually would actually be kind of scary, as Mayan would go flipping with Eric Monaco, the pole sitter there. And Vanderpesh just barely misses that, but Maddie Mayan would go flipping. slipping into the gravel pit, so tough break for Matty Myatt, who has had a horrible season opener. Contact between Lamas and Benoit Lotharivine, as Lamas has no hood anymore. Actually, that was the contact between Matty Myatt and Cody Lamas that caused Lamas to lose his hood, as Clara Irwin goes up through the order there. Oh, Eric Monaco's got a lot of damage to that car there as well. As now, Kenny Myatt, with only three to go, is trying to lap Hashimoto there and gets by cleanly. Kenny Myatt's on the final lap here at Road Atlanta, and this has been a thoroughly dominating performance, or the end of the race has been at least. It was chaotic in the middle part. Oh, hopped, and Jacob Hart got into a wreck! And we missed those two wrecking, but they wrecked in the chicane down there as Kenny Myatt continues to lead this race. Who's going to be in the second? Vanderpesh is second. And that actually elevates Noah Hart to third. And with that, Kenny Myatt comes out the final quarter. He's going to come home to win his sixth, count them, sixth Grand Prix of Road Atlanta here at here in Georgia. Christian Vanderpesh brings it home second position. Third's going to go to Noah Hart. Fourth is actually going to be Sean Perkins. Actually, no, this is a close battle here. Sean Perkins actually might catch Noah Hart. See that in a second here. I thought I saw Kurt also spin off earlier, but guess not. Third is going to go to Noah Hart, and fourth is going to go to Sean Perkins, I believe, because I don't like Perkins at the time, for the car to catch Noah Hart in this little bit left. Yep. Hart third, Perkins fourth, and then fifth is going to go to Jesse Turner in the Fusion Sport car. Let's go down to your full finishing results. So, Kenny Myatt is your pole sitter, is your winner today here at Road Atlanta again. Christian Vanderpesh brings her home second. Noah Hart third, Sean Perkins fourth, Jesse Turner fifth, Maverick Force, great job for the rookie of the race there. Johannes Rudavara from Sweden comes home seventh. Nick Perkeles eighth, Benoit Lotharivine ninth, Clara Irwin rounds out your top 10, Lamas 11th, Ratzenberger, 12th, Hashimoto 13th, Haupt 14th, Hart 15th, those cars were not technically considered out of the race. 16th goes to Eric Monaco, 17th to Alexander Spencer, and then the car's out of the race. Matty Myatt, Vince Freeze, DJ Curtis, Zachary Fitzwater, Tyler Thaber, Aiden Shepard, Do It For Dale Jr., and Tim Fiegel. And let's take a look at your, well, we'll do points at the next race. How does that sound? Because the points are kind of self-explanatory here. So with that being said, we will see you at round number two of the season.